On Thursday, May 25, 2017, Nigeria witnessed a rare, courageous and righteous ruling by a judicial officer when Justice Muhammad Idris of the Federal High Court Lagos ordered the Department of State Services DSS to release the MD of Capital Oil and Gas Limited, Dr. Ifeanyi Ubah, from detention. In the 100-page judgment, Justice Idris ordered the DSS to release from detention unconditionally if no criminal action is instituted against him within 48 hours of this judgment. The fact that another federal high court in Abuja gave what appears to be a conflicting ruling within minutes of the earlier judgment does not in any way, shape or form diminish the solemn truth spoken by the ruling of the Federal High Court Lagos. It is important to consider some of the nuggets of that ruling, which may yet prove a prophetic warning to the federal government of Nigeria if it is indeed committed to the tenets of true democracy. In his ruling of May 25, 2017, Justice Muhammad Idris of the Federal High Court Lagos stated the following. 1. Security agencies must know that they are not instruments of debt recovery. 2. Democracy cannot be successful if the respect for rule of law and constitution is shaking. 3. Such a man should no longer be relevant, a man who doesn't obey court orders and rule of law. 4. We must, as a nation, ensure that human rights are protected. 5. No institution or agency of government should be above the law. 6. DSS, as an agent of government, must learn how not to lie to the court of law. 7. Counsel must be honest and truthful to the court. The continued deceit and lying to this court by DSS counsel may warrant their arrest. 8. Why keep him, Dr. Ifeanyi Ubah, beyond a law-stipulated time without charging him to court of competent jurisdiction? What is worrisome is the fact that the DSS continues, in spite of truth and logic, to hold Dr. Ifeanyi Ubah without charge, breaching his fundamental human rights without qualms. In any case, it must be noted that by unjustly detaining Dr. Ifeanyi Ubah without charge, the authorities are themselves culprits of the same allegation of economic sabotage which they level against him. To prove this, the organized labor under the auspices of the United Labor Congress in a statement rightly argued that the continued incarceration of Dr. Ubah was undermining the job security of over 2,000 employees of the company and that it contradicts the federal government's promise to create jobs. But what is Dr. Ubah's offense anyway? The DSS accuse him of diverting petrol valued at over 11 billion naira lodged at his tank farm by the NNPC. Thankfully, it admits that it owes the same Dr. Ubah about 16 billion naira. But suppose for the sake of argument that Dr. Ifeanyi Ubah did commit an offense. It is simply a breach of contract which is redeemable by a penalty, not arrest and detention without charge. According to Dr. Ubah's counsel, Ifeoma Esom, Capital Oil and Gas has entered into throughput agreements in accordance with the norms and practice of the industry worldwide, which allow conversion and diversion of its products in terms of the current contract within 7 days of demand by the product's owner or to pay a penalty for non-delivery. One shudders to think of the consequences if, following government example, ordinary citizens resort to the use of might to settle disagreement. Release Dr. Ifeanyi Ubah. Ifeanyi Ubah, Ifeanyi Ubah, leave Ifeanyi Ubah alone. This is not intimidation, no go walk, leave Ifeanyi Ubah.